little bit of a backstory on today's two plays. They're set in the Victorian age, which was named after Queen Victoria, who was a long-standing queen of England, and so during a time of great change. This change was the Industrial Revolution, and for many people it provided a middle-class lifestyle and a better life. But for a vast majority, it was a time of suffering and agony. Tonight's plays show both sides of this time period. In Alice in Wonderland, Alice is a girl who lived in a life of support and ease, while Tiny Tim has to fight for what he has. Please enjoy our show.
You got into?
Once upon a time,
in merry old England,
there was a man called
Lewis Carroll.
How do you do?
Do.
How do you do? How do you do?
How do you do?
And a little girl named Alice.
Have you seen a little girl about this tall in a blue dress?
Yeah.
Where?
Yeah.
Over here?
There.
Here? There? Where? Alice, you must come out this instant. Well, good heavens, how many Alices do we have here? Why, there's...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
My goodness, I'm afraid that's too many Alices for the moment. We'll start with just one.
And so all the Alices sat down to wait their turn.
Oh my stars, Alice, aren't you ashamed of yourself?
I'm sorry for hiding, Mr. Carroll, but I wanted to go out and play.
Now, I mustn't lose a bit of time. Sit down here, Alice.
Beg your pardon, Mr. Carroll, but just what are we late for?
Mr. Carroll was always scampering about, like a rabbit.
He was always telling stories, you see.
And sometimes even he couldn't tell what was real.
And what he made up.
I'm not sure, but I know we mustn't be late. Now, sit.
Oh, but Mr. Carroll, must I sit there now? It's such a nice day for playing.
Sit.
When he wasn't making up stories,
he was taking pictures with his newfangled camera.
It was a great hobby of his.
Now, say cheese. Yes, that's very good. But could you just lift your chin higher? Higher still. Now move your right shoulder. Hold your right hand out. And hold your back straight. Put your left arm behind you. Now sit up.
Fiddlesticks! I wish you'd tell me a story instead. Remember the one about the white rabbit?
And the cat that disappeared?
Yes, and the caterpillar and the queen.
Off with their head!
Yes, she said that all the time, but I remember when it was all over, I couldn't decide if you told the story or if I dreamed it. It was all so real.
And what was the place called, Alice?
Wonderland.
Do you think you could pose for me if I tell you about Wonderland?
I think so, but I'm getting very sleepy.
Just relax, Alice.
So sleepy.
If I'm going to tell you a story, we need a little song to begin. Shall I sing you a song?
Oh yes, I love songs.
Let's see if the others might help. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. Do you know that one?
Yes.
Alice is so sleepy, we must sing quietly.
Twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are.
Oh yes, I know that one. Twinkle, twinkle, little bat, how I wonder where you're at. Oh dear, is that right?
Go on, Alice.
Up above the world you fly, like a tea tray in the sky. Oh dear, that's not at all how I remember it. Up above the world you fly, like a tea tray in the sky.
Mustn't be late, Alice.
Oh no, mustn't be late, mustn't be.
Late.
Oh dear, I shall be too late. I shall be too late.
Bad idea!
Wait, look! He's gone into his rabbit hole!
Suddenly, Alice felt herself falling.
Whoa!
Falling!
Whoa!
I never fell so low.
It seemed like years.
Finally, she hit the bottom.
Who are you? That's not a very polite way of introducing yourself.
Whatever are you doing in my rabbit hole? I suppose you're going to say you fell from the sky?
Well, no. As a matter of fact, I remember chasing a rabbit. He was running so fast and saying,
"All my ears and whiskers."
Yes, exactly like that. And he had a pocket watch.
Like this one?
Yes. And he kept saying,
oh dear, I shall be too late. Well, goodbye.
I'm sure you mean hello. I only just got here.
Goodbye, hello.
I wish you'd make up your mind.
No time for that. I'm going to be late.
Late for what?
Difficult to say, very difficult to say.
But if you don't know what it is you're late for.
No time for that now. Hello?
But wait. He's gone. How very strange.
Alice found herself in a long, low hall, lit up by a row of lamps.
Along one wall she found.
A door? I guess nobody's home. I'll just open it and lock. Oh dear, how will I ever get back home?
Suddenly, Alice came upon a four-legged table, all made of glass.
There was nothing on it but a tiny golden
key.
Alice noticed the tiny door about 15 inches high.
The key fit,
but it was no bigger than a mouse hole.
Who could ever fit in there? But look, that is the loveliest garden I've ever seen. Oh, how I wish I could go in there. Now let me see, maybe my head would fit. It's no use. But even if my head would go through, it would be no use without my shoulders. I don't remember that being there before. The label says,
drink me.
Well, it doesn't say poison, so it must be safe.
It tasted like cherries.
And pineapple.
Goes to turkey and poppy.
Oh, what a curious feeling.
And Alice began to get smaller and smaller and smaller.
Whoa! Look how tiny my hand has become. And look at my tiny little feet. What if this just goes on and I shrink away to nothing?
But Alice did stop shrinking.
Phew, now I can fit through the door. Look, I'm smaller than that mushroom. Maybe it's a magic mushroom. There's nothing under it. There's nothing on this side. And nothing on this side. Well, I might as well see what's on top. Oh!
Who are you?
I don't know, Mr. Caterpillar.
What do you mean by that? Explain yourself.
I can't explain myself. I'm afraid, sir, because I'm not myself, you see.
I don't see.
I can't seem to stay the same size for more than 10 minutes at a time.
What size do you want to be?
Well, I would like to be a little larger. 3 inches is a terrible height to be.
It's a very good height indeed. I'm exactly 3 inches high.
But I'm not used to it.
You'll get used to it in time. One side will make you go taller, and the other side will make you go shorter.
One side of what? The other side of what?
The mushroom, of course.
The mushroom? One side will make me grow taller, and the other side will make me grow shorter. But which side is which?
Hey, that hurts.
I'm terribly sorry. Taller, shorter, shorter, taller. I'll just try a little of this one.
Alice began to grow so fast and so high.
Whoa!
And when she looked down,
her head was above the trees.
Oh, I can't see my feet at all.
Hiss.
Before she knew what happened,
a large pigeon had flown into her face.
Look, Mama, it's a great big bird.
It's not a bird you're doing, that's a serpent.
Mama, that's calling me names.
I'm Mom.
Stay behind me, children. Grab a tail feather. Now let's go for her.
Serpent.
I am not a serpent.
A serpent, I say. You're after my hatchlings and my eggs. I know you serpents.
You tell him, Mama.
Better watch out, you serpent.
Don't mess with Mama.
I'm very sorry if I've annoyed you. I build my nest in the highest tree I can find, and what happens? Another one comes wriggling down from the sky.
Oh, serpent.
But I'm not a serpent, I tell you. Well, what are you then?
She's trying to make something up.
I'm not. I'm a little girl.
A likely story indeed. I've seen a great many little girls in my time, but none of them with a neck as long as yours.
No use denying it.
I suppose you'll be telling me that you don't eat eggs then.
I do eat eggs, of course, but little girls eat eggs just as much as serpents do.
I don't believe it. At any rate, you're looking for eggs, so what does it matter if you're a little girl or a serpent?
It matters a good deal to me, but I'm not looking for eggs, and if I was, I wouldn't want yours. I don't like them raw.
Well, be off then.
That's telling them, Mama.
Yeah, and don't come back.
Stay behind me, children. No playing in the clouds. Hail, feathers! Hail, feathers!
Trouble getting along with people before. I must get back to my right size. Whoa! There, that's about right. The exact size a little girl should be. Now, the next thing I must do is find my way back to that pretty little garden.
Twinkle, twinkle, little bat, how I wonder where you're at. Up above the world so high, like a tea tray in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little bat, how I wonder where you're at. Ah, the March Hare! What a pleasure, what a delight. Welcome to my tea party.
How very thoughtful of you.
Now, please, have a seat, right there. No, not there, are you mad? Of course not. Please, right here. Oh, so sorry, so dreadfully sorry. Did I say there? No, that will never do. You will sit right here. The Dormouse. How kind of her to join us. You may sit in the teapot.
Not at all.
No. Well, then you'll do nicely as my pillow. Did you squeak? Mustn't complain, Dormouse. No complaining at my tea party. Is that understood? Now puff yourself up. That's better, and try to stay awake.
A tea party? Oh, I would love some tea.
No room.
But there's plenty of room.
Have some juice.
I don't see any juice.
There isn't any.
Then it wasn't very civil of you to offer it.
It wasn't very civil. You stalled without being invited.
I didn't know this was your table. You have all these places set, and there are only three of you.
Why is a raven like a writing desk?
Riddle? I love riddles. I believe I can guess that one.
You mean you can find the answer to it?
Well, yes.
Well, what day of the month is it?
The fourth.
No, 2 days wrong.
What a funny watch. It tells you the day of the month, but it doesn't tell you the time.
Why should it? Does your watch tell you what year it is?
Of course not. But that's only because it stays the same year for such a long time.
Twinkle, twinkle.
Stop that! Stop that!
Oh, but I love that song. Twinkle, twinkle.
Stop it, the both of you.
It's just a song.
Just a song? Just a song? She sang it before the queen, you know?
Really? Did she like it?
Like it? She'd hardly finished the first verse before the queen bawled out, off with her head!
How dreadfully savage!
Take some more tea.
But I haven't had any yet, so it's impossible for me to take more.
You mean you can't take any less? It's very easy to take more than nothing.
This is all so impossible!
I want a clean cup. Let's all move down one.
You just keep moving around the table like that.
Of course. We keep moving as all the cups get used up.
Ha! But what happens when you get to the beginning again?
Suppose you change the subject.
This is the stupidest tea party I've ever been at in all of my life.
How rude.
The very idea. Come, March Hare. Dormouse. We'll do very nicely without her, I'm sure.
Just as the Mad Hatter disappeared, Alice noticed a tree that had a door leading right into it.
How very strange, but everything's changed today. I may as well go in.
Found herself in a beautiful garden.
A large rose tree stood near the entrance. What pretty flowers!
The roses growing on them were white, but
there were several gardeners busily painting them red.
Would you tell me, please, why are you painting those flowers?
We paint them every day, don't you see?
But why?
Everyone needs to change days.
But roses are so pretty anyway.
Pretty to you, perhaps, but how about those like a blue?
Or purple.
Or chartreuse.
But roses don't come in those colors.
Don't matter what, the queen wants them red today.
And there's nothing for it but to paint them red, don't you see?
That is, you'd like to keep your head about it.
Well, I think it's a waste of time, not to mention paint.
Don't even think of crossing the queen, young lady.
Her Majesty should come along and see these roses were white. If she had her heads cut off, she would.
Oh, how beastly!
Suddenly, the gardener saw a terrible sight.
The queen!
Oh no, the queen, the queen!
The queen! Ah! Oh!
Thank you, my royal subjects. You're all so small and worthless. It warms my heart. Who is this?
My name is Alice, so please, your majesty.
You may kiss my hand. Ah, how sweet. What is this I see? White roses, off with this girl's head.
Nonsense.
Off, off, off. Can you play croquet?
Yes, I can.
Come then, croquet everyone. Get to your places. May I remind you, a moment's delay will cost you your lives.
Well, but this isn't a place for croquet at all. It's all ridges and furrows, and the balls are live hedgehogs, and the mallets are
one for you, one for me.
Flamingos?
Arches, arches! Where are my arches? If something isn't done about this in less than no time, I will have execution all around.
you and you, come with me.
Live people for archers?
Absolutely. Very good, and now we shall begin. Who shall go first?
Oh, you may go first, Your Majesty.
Excellent choice. You grip your flamingo like so. Stop that! Off with this flamingo's head!
But, Your Majesty, you couldn't play if the flamingo lost its head.
Ah, yes. Quite right. You grip your flamingo like so, gently tapping the hedgehog, like so. You see, Alice?
But you,
Yes, yes, I know. I'm a remarkable croquet player. Don't you agree? Well, don't you? I order you to applaud. And now, Alice, let's see you try.
All right.
Hold it. Go on.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Hold it.
Yes, Your Majesty?
Continue. Interesting.
May I use yours?
Go on. You missed!
But, Your Majesty, how can the hedgehog go through the arch if you told him to kick it? And why did my flamingo's head fall off?
Let's not have any sour grapes, young lady. Boo, I order you to boo! You really must work on winning the affection of the crowd, Alice.
I think.
You think?
I think you cheat, Your Majesty.
What?
I don't think you play fairly at all. You don't seem to have any rules. At least if you do, nobody follows them.
Off with your head!
Nonsense! You must have a trial before you cut off anybody's head.
I must?
You must.
Is that true?
Yep. Uh-huh. Sure is.
Let the trial begin. Alice, hand me my wig.
Oh, yes, of course.
Alice had never been in a court of justice before.
But she had read about them in books.
She was quite pleased to know that you should hear the names of nearly everything there.
That's the judge, that's the witness stand, and that's the jury.
Silence in the court. Members of the jury, consider your verdict.
Oh, Your Majesty, not quite yet. There is a great deal to come before then.
Ah, yes, of course.
Call the first witness.
Call the first witness. Alice, step up to the stand. What do you have to say about this? A letter written to somebody? What do you have to say about that, Alice?
Is it in my handwriting?
No.
Well then?
You must have imitated somebody else's writing.
Nonsense. Look at the bottom. I never signed that letter.
If you never signed it, it proves you're guilty. If you weren't guilty, you would have signed it like an honest person.
That doesn't prove anything of the sort.
Sentence. Let us have the sentence.
But you don't have your verdict yet.
Sentence first, verdict afterward.
Nonsense, that idea.
Hold your tongue.
I won't.
Off with her head. Off with her head.
Begging pardon, Your Majesty, but I think we'd all like to say off with your head. What do you think? Off with her head?
Off with her head.
Off with her head.
Treason. This is treason, I say.
Off with her head. Off with her head.
What is this? A herd of Alice's? I won't have this. No, if I want Alice at a time.
Off with her head.
Treason! This is treason, I
off
say!
Off with their head!
Off with their head!
Off with their head!
Treason! Off with their head!
We sang for Alice.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how how I wonder what you are.
Excellent photograph, Alice. Excellent.
Photograph? But you, oh, I, the queen. She was here, oh, Mr. Carroll. The queen, she was here. And the Mad Hatter and the strangest tea party. And I heard going down and up and up.
Yes, you are.
I am what?
Growing up. It won't be long now. And you'll be as grown up as me, with children of your own.
That is still a long time.
Not as long as you think, really. Why do you think I take so many pictures?
Oh, Mr. Carroll, will you tell my children of Wonderland?
You may have to do that for me. Do you think you can?
Of course. There's a Cheshire Cat who was always grinning, and the White Rabbit who always lost his gloves and was always in a hurry. Mr. Carroll, you are in a hurry too. Do you think we can take our time this time?
Yes, Alice. Let's take our time.
Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, you're all too kind. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Charles Dickens, renowned author, writer extraordinaire, and of course, your humble servant. I shall begin today's reading of A Christmas Carol. Marley was dead to begin with, there is no doubt of that.
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, who are you?
Yeah, this is our show.
Yeah, we've been rehearsing all week. What's the big idea?
Your show? My dear little friends, I assure you, I am the famed, prestigious, and illustrious writer Charles Dickens, and this is indeed my show.
Mrs. Drama Teacher!
Now, kids, this isn't how we rehearsed it, is it?
But he's stealing our lines.
Yeah, we're the storytellers.
Oh, dear Mr. Dickens, we're honored to have you. It's just the kids are pounding on being the storytellers today.
Who the Dickens do they think they are? It says right here, A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens, yours truly.
So it does, Mr. Dickens. I was wondering if we might ask you a favor.
This story is all about generosity. I shall grant you a favor.
Well?
We want to do it our way.
Yeah, we want all the kids to play the parts, and we want everybody in the audience to be part of the show.
Oh dear, that's a little unusual, isn't it?
And we want everybody to sing Christmas carols with us.
We want everyone to have a good time. After all, it's Christmas, isn't it? Well, isn't it?
Yes.
Very well, in the spirit of the season, perhaps you should take your...
My seat, yes, of course. Break a leg, kids.
And the rest of you? Now, as I was saying, Marley was set to begin with, there is no doubt of that.
Excuse me, Mr. Dickens, sir?
Patience. What is it?
There's a lot more to come before that, sir.
Well, how do you think the story should begin?
On Christmas Eve!
Snow was falling everywhere.
Kids were throwing snowballs.
People were putting up their Christmas trees.
Hanging the mistletoe.
Buying presents.
And hurrying home to get ready for...
Christmas Day!
Everybody sing with us.
But on this fearfully sad day, there is one man who did not wish anyone a Merry Christmas.
Humbug, to the lot of you!
Ebenezer Scrooge is sitting in his counting house.
He left us sit and count and figure how much money he had,
because Scrooge loved money.
Scrooge had one man who worked for him.
Poor Bob Cratchit.
He had only a piece of coal
and the light of one candle to keep him warm.
Master Scrooge.
Dare you speak to me when you should be working?
I'm sorry, Master Scrooge. It's just that.
What? What? Out with it!
Well, I was wondering if I might...
So, you want Christmas Day up again this year, do you?
It would be ever so kind of you to grant it to me, all of my children and my dear wife. Well, you would make them very happy, sir.
Very well. I'll think about it. Back to work!
Suddenly, there was a cheerful voice.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas, Uncle Scrooge.
Bob! Humbug!
What do you have to be cross about?
This Christmas that you love so much is robbing me blind! No one pays their bills, no one pays their rent.
But Uncle, surely you're rich enough.
I lose money every Christmas, and takes me half the year to make it up. Just ask him. Cratchit over there. He's planning to steal another day's wages for this Christmas foolery.
Oh, hello there, Mr. Cratchit. Merry Christmas to you.
Don't say it! Not under my roof.
I came to ask you Christmas dinner, Uncle.
I'll be too busy doing his job of mine, too.
Well, you can change your mind.
I won't. Good day to you.
I asked you last year, and I'll ask you again next year. Maybe someday you'll change your mind. Say Merry Christmas to your family for me, Mr. Cratchit.
You're very kind, sir.
Next came two unsuspecting women, Miss Mary and Miss Glee.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays to you all. Mr. Scrooge, we're here to collect for the poor. Just half a shilling will feed the family.
Are there no prisons? No workhouses?
But the children, sir.
Are there no orphanages?
Very cold winter. Some of the poor may die without our help.
That is no business of mine. Good day, ladies.
Merry Christmas, sir.
What are you doing?
If you please, sir, it is my quitting time.
And you leave right at the minute? You expect me to give you a whole day, and you can't give me a minute.
I'll come early in the morning after, sir.
See that you do. Don't say it!
Again, Scrooge heard a cheerful sound.
There are carolers right outside his window. It sounded as if the whole town was singing.
God rest, ye merry gentlemen.
Fog and frost hung about Scrooge's old house like a mournful ghost as he made his way to the front door.
Old Scrooge once had a partner named Jacob Marley,
but Marley had been dead for 7 years. Scrooge didn't miss Marley or even think about him,
but for some reason this night,
Scrooge looked upon his door knocker and saw Marley's face.
Marley! You must be getting old, Scrooge. There's no face in that knocker. Bah! Ah! It must be nothing. What was he used to say, Jacob? Christmas is the poor excuse to pick him out of his pocket every year? How true, how true.
Maybe the door knocker didn't frighten him.
Humbug.
Maybe the darkness didn't spook him.
Bah!
Maybe the shadows didn't scare him.
Ha!
But he double locked his doors just the same.
Come, blessed sleep, come.
As Scrooge drifted away, it seemed a choir of angels sang him to sleep.
Silent night, glory night, the birds fly.
If I was your partner, Jacob Marley.
It can't be true.
You don't believe in me.
Not at all. You're nothing but a stomach cramp, a bit of undigested meat.
Ebenezer Scrooge!
Oh, ghost! Oh, ghostly thing! Terrible, terrible ghostly thing!
Marley!
Marley? Why have you come to me in this way?
I am doomed.
Doomed?
Doomed?
In life, I show no kindness. I offer no happiness. Now I am doomed.
Doomed!
To wander the world and see what I cannot share on earth. I am bound in my chains. Chains of my own making.
Your own making?
Do you not see? My chains are made out of cash boxes, keys, ledgers, padlocks, the things I worshipped in life.
But you're always a good businessman.
Mankind was my business. Charity, mercy, kindness were all my business. At Christmas, I suffer the most. Why did I not see the poor? The hungry, the needy.
You're awfully busy.
Listen! My time is nearly gone. You have a chance to escape my fate, Ebenezer Scrooge.
Oh, yes, yes. Thank you, thank you. I'm very glad to hear it.
You will be haunted by three spirits. Expect the first when the bell tolls one. Look to see me no more. Remember what has passed between us.
As these terrible and troubling images fell away, Scrooge fell into a deep, deep sleep.
Little did he know, little did he dream, of the Christmas that was soon to come.
Why have you come?
Your welfare.
Well, that is very kind of you, but I think I'll stay here in bed.
Rise!
Rise!
Walk with me.
Walk with me!
But you seem to fly, don't you? I'm a mere mortal. I'll fall.
Take my hand.
Fly!
Thank you.
Scrooge saw that they stood upon an old country road.
Do you recognize it?
Recognize it? I was a boy here.
Show me the way, Scrooge.
It's just past that gate, and then that tree, and then this post.
Soon they came to a schoolyard filled with children.
Hey, Ted, catch.
Why, it's Ted Spurley, Ted, and Harry Barnface.
Got it.
Over here, boys.
They cannot see us, Scrooge. These are things I've been.
Hey, race to the schoolhouse.
You're on.
The schoolhouse is deserted, yet there's one boy there, all alone. You recognize him?
Oh, that's me, poor boy, all alone on Christmas. While all the other boys ran off to their families, I remained here in the schoolhouse.
But there was one time.
Yes, there was one time.
Ebenezer!
Fran, is it really you?
Yes, it's me, you silly. Father is so much nicer these days. He sent me here to come and take you home for Christmas.
Wow, Fran, look at you. Look how much you've grown.
She has such a good heart.
She died young, didn't she?
Yes.
She had one child, a son.
My nephew.
What is it, Scrooge?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking how I spoke to my nephew this morning. My sweet Franny's son.
Soon, they came to the city. And there goes the Christmas past, stopped at the warehouse door.
Do you know this place?
Know it. I was an apprentice here.
Yo-ho there, boys. It's Christmas come at last.
Old Fezziwig! I worked for him, but he was like a father to me.
Ebenezer, Dick, off from behind those desks.
Why, it's Dick Wilkins. He was my best friend.
Push everything to the walls, boys. It's time for the Christmas dance.
And so it was. Everyone forgot their work and had the jolliest time you ever saw. And their favorite Christmas carol of all,
by Deck the Halls, of course.
Everyone, deck the halls.
Nothing like Christmas, is there? Nothing like it at all.
All that food and merriment must have cost Master Fezziwig a pretty penny.
So what? The happiness he gave people was priceless.
And the people who worked for him?
It never seemed like I worked for him.
What did it seem like?
Well, like we were friends.
What is it, Scrooge?
Oh, nothing. I was just thinking how I spoke to my clerk this morning.
Walk with me, Scrooge. There's still another Christmas to visit.
They walked until they reached a small house with a modest parlor.
But Belle, I don't understand. What are you trying to tell me?
We met when we were both young and poor, I believe. We were alike then, but you've changed.
How have I changed?
You don't love me anymore.
Belle, I do.
No, Ebenezer, I can see it plainly. You love your money most of all.
It's so bad to make profit to improve one's standing.
But it's all you really care about. I must return this to you.
Well, no.
Goodbye.
No more! I don't want to see you anymore!
I told you, Scrooge, these are things I've been. They are what they are.
I can't bear it. Take me back.
Very well. Take my hand. Goodbye, Master Scrooge. I shall not come again. Sleep well.
And once again, Scrooge began to slumber.
Did not hesitate. She took Scrooge straight to the home of Bob Cratchit.
First came Mrs. Cratchit. Though her dress had seen many years, she disguised its age with many brave ribbons. What could be keeping your father, children? He went to church with Tiny Tim. They should have been home half an hour ago.
Why, look, there he is, Mother.
Just in time. We have a mighty goose to eat. Alas for poor Tiny Tim, he used a little crutch and his legs were held up by an iron frame.
Bob! Father! Now come here, the both of you. Warm yourself by the fire. And how did our golden boy behave?
He told me, coming home, that he hoped everybody saw him in church today because it might be pleasant for them to remember who made lame beggars walk and blind men see.
Why is everyone frowning? It's Christmas. When do we eat? Mother, can we start with the pudding?
Tiny Tim, you know very well. The pudding comes after. Martha, Peter, set the table.
Oh,
It's as big as a house.
It's as big as me.
Why, it's quite a small bird. What's everyone going on about?
It's time for the pudding. Mrs. Cratchit is very nervous.
Ooh! Ah!
Wow. It's quite a small pudding for such a large family.
Merry Christmas to us all, my dears. God bless us.
God bless us, everyone.
Spirit, tell me, if Tiny Tim will live.
I see a vacant place at that table.
Oh, no.
Time will tell if nothing changes in the future.
So it can be changed? We can change the future?
Another toast.
A toast to Mr. Scrooge, founder of the feast.
Founder of the feast, indeed. How can you toast to such a hard, stingy, odious, unfeeling man?
But my dear, it's Christmas Day.
I'll toast to Mr. Scrooge because it is Christmas. I'm sure he and his money are having quite a holiday.
Take me away, Spirit.
Will you turn your back again, Scrooge? Will you ever look and see what is before you?
Well, I see poor Tiny Tim there.
Tiny Tim is one of many.
But are there no charities? No foundations?
No prisons? No workhouses? No
workhouses? Please stop, please.
Once again, in the final time, Scrooge heard the bell strike.
One.
The phantom slowly, gravely, silently approached.
Spirit of the future, I fear more than any I have seen. Have you come to save me? I wish to become a new man in the future. Yes, Spirit, I will follow.
Scrooge was at a street corner he knew very well.
Hey, I know these men. They're businessmen like me.
Whoa, ho, did you hear the news?
The old codger died in his sleep.
What's he done with all his money?
You know what a miser he was.
They say you can't take with you, but knowing him,
probably figure out a way.
Well, who, Spirit? Who? Who could they be speaking of?
Value
of it.
A couple boots, shilling, silver teaspoons.
Dig deeper, old Joe.
His bed green?
That might be, but he won't miss them. Have a look.
His blankets.
Still warm, ain't they?
Got a heart as cold as his.
If he wanted love and kindness, he could have given some himself in his better days.
Boy, huh? Oh, Spirit. Who died? Who do they speak of? Tell me.
My dear, don't be grieved. I visited him just now, and it would cheer your heart to see a place so green.
Oh, my little child, my little child.
Well, that's Bob Cratch and his wife. Whatever are they going on about?
I came upon Scrooge's nephew in the streets just now. You know the one? A very decent man. He said he was ever so sorry if there was anything he could do.
No. Come sit by the fire, my dear.
Oh, no.
And together, let's remember him.
None of us will forget Tiny Tim.
What have I done? No.
Scrooge and the spirit walked until they came upon an old iron gate.
Well, what is this? It is a churchyard. I see that well enough.
It was overgrown with grass and weeds. The spirit stood among the graves and pointed down to one.
Spirit, tell me, are these the shadows of things that can and will be changed? Can I change the future?
Still, the spirit pointed.
Whose name is chiseled there?
It says, Ebenezer Scrooge!
As the words fell from his lips, the ghost began to fade.
Oh no, spirit, don't go. Don't leave me here. Please, don't go. Come on, man. I've changed. I will change. Hear me out. Goes to show. I will honor Christmas in my heart, in the past, present, and future. Oh, hear me, spirits. I will change.
This may seem hard to believe, but the next day the sun came up and the event was quite unremarkable. Past, present, and future seemed hardly interested. The only difference from all other days was that it simply was Christmas. From the local chapels, one could hear people sing Joy to the World.
Like a little pets, my friends.
Scrooge woke up and began to behave. What's the word?
Peculiar.
Ah, yes, peculiar.
Oh, I'm alive. Oh, I'm not dead. No, I'm alive. I'm alive indeed.
The old man began to dance about the room.
Oh, spirits. Oh, you have saved me. Now I have time to make amends. Time to be good and kind to my fellow man.
He ran to the window, threw it open, and began calling to the world.
Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, one and all.
He laughed, he cried.
Oh, spirits, you have saved me. Lord, you have saved me as well. Oh, thank you for granting me this gift.
Scrooge saw a little boy walking by.
Hello, ho! Hey, you there, little boy. Do you know what day it is?
What day? Why, Christmas Day, of course.
Oh, of course, I knew that. I just wanted to make sure. Oh, it's Christmas indeed. Oh, little boy, I forgot about you.
Me?
Yes, you. Do you know they sold that prize turkey down at the grocery down by the next street?
What, the one as big as me?
Silly boy, but yet intelligent. Yes. Go and buy it.
It's hanging there right now.
Go and buy it.
You're fooling me.
I wish. Go and buy it and tell them to bring it here. Here, I got something for you. Pay with this. Bring it in less than 5 minutes, I'll give you half a crown, son.
Oh, boy!
Oh, boy, indeed. Oh, I'll bring it to Mr. Cratchit's. It'll be twice as big as Tiny Tim. Oh, it makes me happy. It really does. It makes me laugh, too. And it makes me chuckle and chuckle.
And so he sat and chuckled until he cried. Scrooge walked the streets, greeting everyone the same, young and old, rich and poor, the very same way.
Old man coming through. Hello, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas to you all. Merry Christmas to you, madam.
Madam? Hey, Merry Christmas to your son. How old a young boy look like? I hope you don't have to do my son.
Oh,
Where's the fire stove? Merry Christmas, everyone. Of course you are. Hey, come on, I'm gonna hug for both of you. Come on, please. Oh, it's not
good. Hey, Merry Christmas. I wish I had a hate penny to give you guys, but I don't know what a hate penny is.
Maestro!
Merry Christmas, you guys.
Merry Christmas, you guys.
Change. And it's for the better, if you can tell. No longer a grumpy old man, but now I'm happy.
Happy as a For old man, I can sure jog pretty fast. Merry Christmas, everyone.
He went to the house of his nephew and had a merry time.
Oh, startled me like that, son of a gun. What a good handshake you have there, Fred.
Here, shake the other.
Oh, yes. Good handshake indeed. Hey, so I got that Charlie horse I see you did? I know it's intentional, but, you know, what the heck. Hey. I've been having a lot of nieces and nephews.
You've been to work, haven't you?
Splendid geniuses all be, like I say, music to my ears.
Whoever could it be?
I don't know, dear. Mr. Scrooge!
Turkey time! Lady Cratchit, how all you both look. I mean, I see you two here, making merry, just because Christmas Day. You know what? I'm not going to stand this anymore, Mr. Cratchit. Therefore, I'm going to give you a raise. Yes, a raise indeed. Come on, give your boss a hug. No worries, where's the Christmas boy?
Mr. Scrooge?
Not you two, I want the Christmas boy.
Mr. Scrooge, what a nice surprise.
What a nice surprise, Tiny Tim. Here I am, flesh and blood, heart and soul, just like you, Tiny Tim, just like you. Oh, heavens, bless me.
God bless us, everyone. God bless us, everyone. Everyone.
God bless us, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you.